going to show how to quickly and easily isolate objects that I'm going to end up pulling into InDesign to do some advanced text wrapping, but I want to show how even with something that does not have necessarily blank background as to what we can do to then pull out these flowers. And I'm going to go ahead and select over here on the left toolbar, I'm going to select the magic wand tool. And what I've done is I've gone ahead, this was set pretty low, but right now, since the areas I want to get rid of, I want to get rid of all the background and keep these like nice pink flowers, I want to go ahead and get rid of all this, the black and the green, so that I can then bring it into InDesign for that layout. And I'm going to go ahead and have it kind of high on the tolerance of 50. Got my anti-alias and contiguous as well. So I'm going to go ahead and click on this. So as you can see, it grabs a pretty good area with that set pretty high. And then I'm going to right click and tell it to select similar. So I just got a lot more in there. And then I can even tell it to grow. And we've gotten even more. All right, so over here on this right side, we've got, this flower is completely isolated. This one is, for the most part, there's a couple of areas I still need to catch. All right, so I already have it set up here to add to. A lot of times it might just be set to here, and wherever you would click, that would be the only thing that would take. So if that were the case, you could hold shift and click to add things. See how that little plus sign comes up, right, by holding on the shift. But if you know that you're going to be doing a lot of that, as opposed to having to hold it down, you click on this to add to selection. And so that way, when I click, it grabs that as well, as opposed to it only grabbing that and then deselecting all of this. So I'm going to get these little areas here that are still, I still want. Let's see here. I've got all that. Oh, there's some little thing here. There we go. And then, but I don't necessarily want to have this. So I can do Alt and undo, and click it. But as you can see, right, it didn't quite get all of that. There's some little spots here that when I do the mask, it was still erase. So I can just go ahead and switch over to the lasso tool. And with that, I'll hold the Alt. And that way it'll bring up this minus sign. Let me get into kind of a light area. That way you can see it there, right? So, I've got the Alt. And now when I grab these areas, because I want to keep them, right, it deselects them. And let's see if there's any other little places I might want to add in there. Let's see. Let me get my little magic wand tool and get that little spot in there. And I think that might be about it as far as what I want to be. And I don't want to say erased, right, because we're not actually going to delete the pixels. We're just going to come down here, right, and on this bar, and we're gonna choose the mask. I can say to select the inverse, but I'll show you why. Right, let me just go ahead and say, all right, I'm not thinking about it, and I just kind of click this. I go like, oh wait, I got the opposite of what I needed. Right, so I can Control Z to undo that, or I can come up here to undo that. To make sure that we right click on here and choose select inverse, and now this way it's actually grabbing up the flowers now, as opposed to the background. And then when I click on this mask, right now it has isolated those flowers. I could go ahead and clean up some. I'm not necessarily concerned with that though right now. I might grab these couple of spots because I just want to do a quick thing to show about how to bring these things into InDesign. All right, and get rid of those little spots there. Okay, now I'm going to deselect all that. So now I've isolated those, and it could, like I said, clean this up a little bit more by maybe a little feathering to kind of get rid of the dark and all that. I'm not necessarily concerned with that, because what I'm really kind of wanting is just this transparent area. And so what I need to do is that this actually started off as a JPEG. I need to save it. I'll go ahead and save it as a PNG, because I need a file type that will preserve the transparency, and a JPEG does not. I'm going to save as. I need to save it as a PNG. Sure. And this way you'll see, you know, again, how to like quickly set up a mask in order to isolate these objects.